Die rugby wereldbeker staan op een einde. Dit het gesorg vir heel wat vermaak en natuurlijk ook een paar benauwde oomblikke, maar grotendeels was daar ook een paar verrassings geweest. Ons skakel nou met ons correspondent vanuit Japan, Ulrich Vaubien. Ulrich, so, ons is so net voor die finaal en die Springbokke is een stapje nader om hy wereldbeker terug huis toe te brengen. Verduidelik dalk het vir ons die gevoel en die atmosfeer die afgelopen paar maanden, maar meer specifiek hierdie weekse atmosfeer in aanloop tot die finaal.
Hey Henry, super excited about the World Cup final this weekend. I can't believe we've already gotten to that point, but here we go, and I think we're in with a chance. The atmosphere this World Cup has been really incredible. I think to see how Japanese and Asian people have taken to rugby as a sport and really made it their own, so cool. I've really enjoyed seeing that and being a part of two of the matches. I got to go to South Africa, Canada, and South Africa, Japan, and the atmosphere was really incredible.
Ek moet bieg, Japan het baie van die kijkers verstom met hulle vertoning tijdens die rugby wereldbeker. Maar die vraag, Ulrich, op die stadium is, sou jy sê die feit dat die rugby wereldbeker in Japan aangebied is, het ook so bietjie die persepsie oor die sportsoort in Japan verander?
Absolutely. I think the memories that they have about rugby is the match against South Africa where they beat us 4 years ago. And besides that, not much else. This World Cup has really opened their eyes to see it as a real sport. And I think for some, it's become way more exciting than sports like soccer or baseball. And if you didn't know, I'll just remind you, baseball is super big in Japan. And American football is quite big. So for them to choose rugby over other sports is, it's a big thing. I've seen it in pubs, I've seen it in restaurants, I've seen rugby player posters in train stations, I've seen people talking about rugby where before it would just be foreigners who discuss a rugby match. So this has just been an amazing experience and a revolution for, I think, rugby in Asia and specifically in Japan. Check out these interviews. The atmosphere here in Japan has been quite interesting and I think a lot of Japanese people have learned about rugby. What do you guys think?
I have never watched Rugby World Cup before, but this World Cup held in Japan. So a lot of people watch this tournament. So I have interested in this. I have interested in what rugby.
So good.
Yes.
The last World Cup, after the last World Cup, we have a very interested about the rugby because the Japanese team won the South African team, so many Japanese people have been interested in rugby.
Die groot vraag is, is Japan nog kwaad vir die Springbokke en wie ondersteun hulle op die stadium tydens die finaal? Is it die Springbokke of is it Engeland?
What's been amazing is I actually have conversations with Japanese people about the rugby and rugby players like Faf de Klerk. Everybody loves that short guy with the long blonde hair. So that's been incredible to see and to have these moments of joy and, oh my word, do you think they can take them? How was the match against Japan? And everybody is so kind about the match against Japan. They're so complimentary about the Springboks and they're just so happy that we've made it again past Wales because they don't want to see a team that beat them fail. Isn't that strange? For us in South Africa, if we lose to someone, we don't want that team to be successful, but they have exactly the opposite approach because it means if that team lost to no one else, then Japan still is a really good team because it only lost to the champions.
Who do you think will win?
Van de Klerk.
Faf de Klerk?
Faf de Klerk.
Your favorite?
Yes. South Africa is a good team. Yeah.
We respect the team which broke our team, so we think we want to win to the South Africa, and I pray for the winner to be the South African team.
Right.
Die Springbokke het Japan tydens die rugby wereldbeker gewen, maar kom, ons gaan nie in te veel detail daaroor nie. Ulrich, jy was self ook daar gewees tydens die wedstryd. Vertel ons so bietjie meer, wat was jou gevoel?
The match between Japan and South Africa was really incredible. 95% I think of the crowd was supporting Japan, 5% South Africa, and that 5%, or those 5% were only South Africans, whereas the 95% was every other country in the world. So yeah, I had French people behind me supporting Japan, and yeah, I was basically alone with one or two other South African supporters. So winning that was a little bit nerve-wracking. I thought something going to happen to me, but besides the passion that they had for their team and their support, as soon as they lost, they cheered for South Africa and they were so complimentary of the team. And I thought that that was an amazing quality, and the manners, something we can really learn from. So that really touched my heart, and it was such an amazing privilege to be at the match.
Ulrich, ek hoop jou trui en jou landsvlag is reg. Enige finale woorde of advies aan die Springbokke vir die finaal wat voor lê tussen die Springbokke en Engeland?
I'm so proud of you, and so is the rest of South Africa, and I think many Japanese and other countries now are supporting you against England, and we are rooting for you all the way. We know you've come from a loss in the beginning, but you picked yourselves up and you went from strength to strength. To see the way you conducted yourselves, the manners that you've replicated as you've watched the Japanese and respecting the Japanese even as you beat them, so cool to see. You've really made our country proud. We're so looking forward to watching the final, and you have our support all the way. In Japanese, Ganbatte kudasai. Please do your best. We're all watching. We all love you, and we can't wait for the match.
Nou ja, ons harte klop groen en goud vir hierdie naweke. Springbokke, dis tyd om daai beker terug huis te bring. Alle voorspoed, vir nou is dit aan in Japan met die Springbokke, ja.
Puff the crack. There we go.